Alright. Hello, guys. Well, I thought the video would show a larger space. I don't know. It might show somewhere around here. Hopefully. Oh, this is the new playmat that I have from the new sneak preview. So, it's pretty cool. Also, I guess I'll show off my deck that I use in the sneak preview. Also, I won. I got first place, kinda. So I have a playmat, and I actually got into top 4. Yeah. I believe I was first place, but the top 4 all got the same prize, I believe. Was it? I'm not sure. But I got a kit for getting first place. So this is the promo from the sneak preview. It's a very good promo. And then, from my kit, I got grain, I believe it's grain. Okay, grain is a quintuple, and I also got Reyes from the sneak kit that I won. But other than that, these are what I have for my. I did sort them out through the what's it called grades. I also sorted out them through the, for the witches and stuff. Also, this card. Blaster Blade Revenger Abyss, if you can see that. Yeah, I don't have great lighting here. Hopefully it's alright. Blaster Blade Revenger Abyss. There we go. So, I have an amazing number of triggers, which is 11. Yeah. They change. I did not realize this, but I don't know when they change the format for drafting, because right now how you draft is when you open a pack, you choose a trigger from it. You put it down, and then you choose another card from the pack and put it down as well. So you basically, from the pack you open, you take two cards, one trigger and one. Well, trigger or non-trigger, it doesn't matter. And apparently, in the case, if you get like a Legion Rare, you take both the Legion Rare cards, and then you take a trigger as well. And all of the other players will take two cards from their packs and a trigger. Yeah, apparently it works that way. So, I have one heal trigger, which I miraculously got. I have three stand triggers, two witches and one revenger. I have three criticals, same, two witches and one revenger. And I have four draw triggers, because one is from my pack and the other three was from the other players sending them to me. Great. So that's my 11 triggers, I believe. Yeah, 6, 10, 11. And my starter, amazingly, I only have one because I managed to pass by the other grade zeros away. Did not want even more grade zeros because of the number of triggers I have. Here's my number of grade ones. I have 6 grade ones, which actually 7, including this card. This card is Donna. Donna helped me a lot in the games. First of all, she helped me Soul Blast. When my mate is in the soul. That's one important point. Another point is getting rid of intercepts, yes, and good boosters as well, or attackers. So that was pretty good. Let's see. This. There was one game where I was great stuck at level. Grade 1. So I called this as a rear guard. Wrote a great that right. I believe I wrote that, and I kept using this skill at the front because I had stand triggers, and I kept discarding like great ones from my hand. I was great stuck at great one, and I couldn't get any great twos because I only had like 5 great twos. It was a miracle I could even get first place. I guess. I was lucky enough to get, well, most of the games that I win, I had a pretty good hand, because I had all three grades. But among the, I believe we had five games. I believe, yeah, five games, and out of three games, I had one. It was best out of three for all of the games, all of the matches. Best out of three. So out of the five games, in three of the games, I had one match, or one of the rounds in the match, yeah, where I'm great stuck at one, and that's where I lost. Yeah, so here's my grade twos. I have two of these, and I had two of these. Yeah, so I managed to get a Legion pair off, well, two basically. Also, I have what's this, Dairde, is it? Dairdre? Whatever. Sorry. Inspection Witch Dairdre. She's basically the grade 2 version for the grade 1 that I've showed you. This one. The good thing about these cards is that it doesn't even need your Vanguard to be in Legion. You just need to have the witch name in it. You can Soul Blast one, choose one of your opponent's rearguard circle, and your opponent chooses a grade 0 card from their drop zone, grade 0 or less, even though there's no negative numbers for grades so far, and call it to that rearguard circle, basically replace that rearguard. So it was pretty good, very good card. I also got, well, here are my grade 3s. Besides these, I also have a Fianna. I managed to get a Fianna. So yeah, I have two. Etain was pretty good for an early ride, and I used her Lunar Break to get rid of attacks. Yeah. Also, these cards, my Legion pair. Let's see, Manisa, Witch of Comets, Manisa. And then I got my one copy of Bathtub Car. I had to decide between a few cards because at that point I did not have a lot of great trees, so I decided I should grab one just in case. But in the end, I ended up not quite needing him, but he was good. Most of the time he called my draw triggers out, which is actually a good thing because I don't want to deck myself out, even though I do have legions. And for Fianna, I actually did her legion skill even though I don't have the mate. You can actually do that in the game, but you can only do it once per unit. Basically, if you ride a new unit, you can do it again, even if the mate is not in your deck. Alright, let's see. So, I didn't get this pair during the tournament, but I won the Great Tree from the sneak kit. I wanted to buy more sneak kits, but they weren't selling. Oh well. So, I did not get any Revenger stuff, which I was hoping to get. So I don't know about building Revengers anymore. So yeah, I am pretty happy with what I have. I have, well, these are the main cards I have, and I also have a Fianna which I sold. So that was pretty good. I also got a playmat. Ah, good. So I'm looking forward to the next sneak preview, which is on December for, what's it called, the actual Legion booster set 16, I believe. I'm not sure, might not even be 16, but it's where Thingsaver comes out, or Thingsaver, whatever. However, what I want from the set is nothing quite important. Well, it is important to me. It's the Spike Bearers, so that will be pretty easy to get. Hopefully I'll get it easy, yeah. I guess I'll explain how my games went, or should I? Actually, no, it doesn't even matter. Most of the games are won by triggers, because I have 11 of them. And then, it helped that I had my Legion. I rode the Great Tree. It's here. Is it? No, it's not. let's just have this as a substitute Fianna. I had a Fianna which was 11k, very good against 15k columns, which happens quite often. Yes. It also helped that my opponents, had a lacking number of triggers compared to me. So, also, most of my games that I won is where I have all tree grades in my hand, so chances are me winning are pretty high. Also, I wrote this and then had Legion with this. Most of the time I had Goat at the back boosting, so I did not use his skill most of the time. I believe the only time I used his skill it was when I had two other great trees and I was trying to get this great tree in my hand. Yeah. And my first game, it was stupid. My first two damage checks was these. Yeah, it was pretty bad. So I had to ride my Fianna and use the Legion because I almost decked out. Almost. I had like three cards left, so I returned four. So I had like seven left. Yeah. And I managed to win that game. Woohoo. So yeah. That is about it. I'm pretty happy. Hehe. I actually wanted to build witches, but right now with what I have, I don't think it's quite worth it for now. So yeah, I will not be building any new Shadow Paladin deck. Yep. I do like the mat though. It looks pretty cool. Especially the Legion symbol there. Yeah. Yeah, that is about it. I do hope to get the Thing Saver playmat as well. That would look pretty cool too. Oh my god. Things to do. Thank you guys for watching. I'll talk to you guys next time.